Welcome students, I'm Mamta. Today we are going to take up chapter 4 of class 11th, Human Development. Now, development particularly refers to a pattern of progressive, orderly and predictable changes that begin from conception and go on till old age. Now, let's look at these terms. It's a process of change which starts even before birth. So, it starts from the prenatal stage, a stage where the fetus is in the womb of the mother. That is the stage from which the development starts, the pattern of changes start. Progressive, because it goes on from one stage to the other in different formats. It goes on in all the areas simultaneously. Orderly, we say it because it is a sequence-wise change that happens. It goes on in a particular order. So, that is why it is orderly. Next, we have predictable changes. Now, obviously, the changes are common for everybody, all human beings. It's universal across all cultures. And it starts before birth and goes on till old age. Now, let's look at a fact that development, because we normally think of this term as a positive area only, the change in a growth area. But it can also be decline, that can also be development, because in old age particularly, there is a major decline. Let's look at the various processes of development, that is, the different kinds of development, the different directions in which development takes place across all individuals. First, we have the biological process or the biological development. Now, in the biological area, we are basically talking about the genes, how they are inherited, and they result in certain observable behaviors like height, weight, and the brain development. So, physically, when we look at it, the biological aspect, that is what it develops. Next kind of development that we have is a cognitive development. Cognitive refers to the mental activities, particularly associated with the process of knowing and experiencing. So, whenever an individual is using any kind of mental activity like thinking, attention, problem solving, decision making, all these come in the cognitive development. So, we think and we speak. Next kind of development that we have is a socio-emotional development. Here we look at the changes that occur in emotions, the way a person develops emotionally, in his personality, and of course, in his interaction with other people, that is social development. Now, let's look at the major perspective of development known as the LSP or the lifespan perspective. Now, first point that we have here is development is a lifelong process. So, as the term indicates, it goes on and continues across different stages of life. Second, development is happening in all the different areas. So, different kinds of development are interwoven throughout the lifespan of the person. Next point that we have is development is multidirectional. So, it is simultaneously I'm thinking, my thinking is developing, along with it in the direction of emotions I'm developing, in the direction of body biologically I'm developing, that is this point. Next we have development is highly plastic, that means it keeps on happening, modifying itself flexibly, that is development is plastic. Next it is influenced very strongly by the historical conditions. So, partition era, the changes that occurred at that time were different. From now, the techno era, the changes that are happening in our historical perspective are different. So, which will impact the development of the person? Last point that we have is development is a concern of a number of disciplines. So, when we study sociology, we study about human development. When we study political science, we study about human development. When we study biology, we understand human development. When we study social development in terms of anthropology, again that is development. Next we have is the development term associated and differentiated with other terms, because development is confused with terms like growth. We use them in normal everyday life, so they are interchangeable, but according to psychological perspective, development we've already understood the process of change in terms of different areas and throughout the lifespan. Growth is particularly the increase in the size of the body parts or the change in the organism as a whole biologically. That is the growth perspective. Whereas when we look at maturation, the changes occur according to the biological blueprint. These are orderly changes that happen based on biological blueprint. So this refers to the way an individual inherits the genes. The same genes expresses itself, manifests itself in the behavioral changes and the biological changes. Next we have is evolution. Last concept, which is often confused again with development. Evolution refers to the species-specific changes. So when we talk about Charles Darwin's concept of survival of the fittest, that is where we are saying that every species evolves because it has to adapt, because it has to survive in a particular scenario, in a particular context. So evolution becomes mandatory for person's development. Next we have is the factors influencing development. Now when we talk about the factors, in every concept of psychology, we are normally looking at two major factors. First, we are talking about the hereditary change that results because of genes. Second, we are talking about the environmental influence on the person's development. So when we talk about these two factors particularly, we have the role of what a person has inherited from the parents, from the ancestors. Those genes are going to manifest itself into the way the person looks like, into the way the person behaves. So that we call as a genotype, which is the actual genetic material or a person's genetic heritage. So this is purely inheritance. But there is no guarantee that this is going to reflect itself in the biological setup of the person. It may have a combination, it may depend on the outside environment, because genes are not the only factor which influence development. Both genetic, that is the heredity, and the environment influence a person's development together. Next concept, in the same thing, we have phenotype. Phenotype is when the person's genotype is expressed in observable and measurable characteristics. So, one, we know that the person is having a certain gene, which when reflected in the outside behavior and the outside body characteristics, that we call as the phenotype. So phenotype will have examples like height, weight, eye color, skin color. All these, or particularly when we talk about psychological characteristics, intelligence of the person, personality of the person. Let's look at a study in the same context by Sandra Scar. Now, Sandra Scar believed that environmental patterns provide children, which particularly parents are providing, provide children with the same kind of development that is there in the parent. So genetic predisposition or genetic tendency of a parent affects the growth and the development of a child. So here, normally the example that was given was that in the experiment, what was done through this example was that parents who are intelligent, parents who love reading books, normally when they are encouraging children to read, or even if they can provide books, the books are available, there's a library at home, children are looking at the books around, children are observing parents taking interest in reading, they also start developing this tendency. So this, where the environment provided with the parents along with the genetic predisposition. So the difference in the study was that parents' own genetic predisposition, parents' own tendency, their own interests, their own intelligence level, all these factors influence the way the child starts behaving, because they provide the same environment to the child. So environment by the parent as well as genetic predisposition by the parent both results in the total environment given to the child, and therefore the child starts developing from there. Next very important topic that we have is the context of development. Here we have to understand the background, the environment, how it plays a role. Two major psychologists have done research in this. First, we have the context of development by Yuri Breffenbrenner. According to Yuri Breffenbrenner, we have different systems which are there in the environment which influence our development. First, at the important level next to the child, we have the micro system. Micro, the smallest unit, the closest system to the child, where we have the immediate social environment of the child, the setting, the environment in which the person lives. For example, friends, in fact, immediate family, friends, teachers, that is the normal order. Second system under the same, we have the meso system. Meso refers to the relation between all these contexts in the microsystem. So for instance, a child comes and says that my teacher has said a certain thing, and that is right, not what my friends are telling me, not what my parents are telling me. Or an adolescent's parents are interacting with the friends of the adolescent child. So that is known as the meso system, where the relation between the two systems of the microsystem is interacting. Third, we have the exosystem, which includes major events in the social settings of the child, where the child is not a direct participant, but they are having a major influence on the child's development. For example, the father gets transferred out of a certain place, the residence where the parents are living. So then that is going to have a major influence on the child's development, because a lot of things will change thereafter. That is exosystem. Next, we have the macrosystem, which includes the culture in which an individual lives. So a child born in a certain culture has observed and learned from that culture. Once they shift to another culture, it will change. So cultural influence is the macro system, the larger system. And the last and the distant level from the child's development is the chrono system. Chrono system basically involves those developments that takes place because of a life course of a child, the journey of a child, or the socio-historical circumstances. For instance, the separation of the parents has a major impact on the way the child develops. So that is the chrono system, the largest and the distant, but having an impact. Let's look at the second part of this. This ecological model was given by Durganand Sinha, according to whom we have two layers around us, the environmental layers. The upper layer, or the more visible layer, consists of the home, the school, the friend circle. It has a very important influence on the child's development. It can be seen. So it is the visible layer, and it's the upper layer consisting of the home, the kind of conditions that are prevailing in the home, the kind of space the child is getting at home, the number of people at home, whether the child feels crowded or has his own space, the kind of infrastructure, technological devices provided to the child. It also includes the kind of schooling a child gets, the kind of nature and the quality of schooling, the kind of infrastructure the child, the facilities the child gets an exposure to. Last layer in the same context, the upper layer, we have the interaction and the activities that take place, that go on between the child and the peer group around him. The second layer that we have is not a very visible layer. It's more of a subtle layer, a surrounding layer, a lower layer, which is embedded. And in this surrounding layer of ecology particularly, we are talking about the general geographical environment, the kind of locality a particular child is staying in, the kind of environment in terms of the climate, the weather conditions, the kind of facilities that are available for a child to play, whether parks are available, nature and greenery is available close to home, where the child can go and interact with his friend circle. The number of people in the locality, the density and the condition of the population. We also talking about the infrastructural setting in terms of the kind of institutions the family belongs to. It also refers to the caste system, the class, and the other general socioeconomic factors. The last that we have is the general amenities available to the child, like drinking water, electricity, medium of entertainment, etc. All these are coming in the surrounding layer, or the lower layer, not so visible layer. Let's look at the portion of development we considered today. We started with the meaning of development, understood the differences between development, growth, maturation. We also understood the aspect of factors which influence development, particularly genetics and environmental factors. And from there on, we moved on to understanding genotype and phenotype related to it. And then we moved on to the concept of context of development, where we understood two major models, starting from the ecological model of Durganand Sinha, and then moving on to contextual model, particularly by Yuri Bronfenbrenner. That's about it in today's session. Thank you.